Hello friends, welcome back to Tanuki Mike's final Terminator 2 review of the week. The ultimate T-800. Dun-dun-dun-dun-dun. Figure comes packaged with this thing on his shoulder, but it's a separate piece, so we'll just take it off. If we can take it off. Yeah, we can. And then we'll look at the sculpt without it. And I gotta say, this sculpt is just pure cool. It's like a leather jacket, and it's what he was wearing in the movie. And they sculpted a bunch of bullet holes in the back from when he gets shot in the mall by the T-1000 a bunch of times. So I really like the pants for some reason. These are different pants than the Terminator from the first movie. And there's so many folds. They just went nuts with the folds this time. Folds in the leather jacket, too. I love the details there. I love the little belt loops and buckles that are hanging off the leather jacket. I love the sculpted belt buckle on his belt and the folds in his shirt. And you can see those awesome pecs popping through. And I love the sunglasses sculpted as a separate piece on the head. I love everything about this sculpt. It reeks of cool. Just like an Arnold Schwarzenegger figure should. If we look up close at the paint, I really love the glossy black they used for the sunglasses. My only real complaint is there's a little bit of a scuff mark on the right cheek up there, and his lips seem a little too purple, but those are pretty minor. Other than that, he doesn't have a lot of paint. He's got a wash all over. Looks great. They got little details of the silver on those zippers. I love that. I love that they got that. Silver on the straps and the belt buckles and the zippers on his boots, too. They did a great job with the paint in general. It's just a couple scuff marks on the face that bother me. Now it's articulation time. The Ultimate T-800 has a good deal of articulation. He moves at the base of the neck with a ball joint. He's got nothing in the chest. This is one solid sculpt. It doesn't bother me so much, but he's got cut waist. He's got hinge and swivel shoulders, but they only go out that far and kind of squeaky because of the leather jacket, even though it's not real leather. He's got hinge and swivel elbows. He's got ball joints at the wrist. They get that much range. He's got ball joints at the hips, go in and out. He has a thigh cut on the left leg, but not the right leg. He's got hinge and swivel knees on both legs, and he's got ball joint ankles on both legs. And then he has a shin cut here for no reason. Not on that leg, just on the left leg. So he's got two cuts on the left leg that he doesn't have on the right leg. And I don't know what the reason for that is. Randy on Twitter says there's some reason for that down the line, but honestly, it's probably just because they're reusing an old sculpt that had that random ass articulation Nika used to do, and they just added good articulation but didn't bother to take out the old pointless articulation. But that's not a problem. The only real problem is no diaphragm joint, but that's a very minor thing. Awesome articulation. Instead of 80s awesome like the first Terminator movie, this packaging's got 90s cool. Look at cool Arnold in his cool leather black jacket. The window box opens up, you can see the Terminator, but more importantly, you can see explosions, because it's better than 1990s explosions, am I right, guys? I love the rest of the packaging. It's pretty easy to get to the figure inside, just one twist tie. No problems with it. It's awesome. Really cool. My favorite time, as always, is accessories time. The Ultimate T-800 comes with 4 different guns and 2 alternate heads to make for a total of 3 heads. The first head is just Arnold without his sunglasses. It's a great head sculpt, and the paint's even cleaner than the sunglasses head that I have, but honestly, it's kind of boring. I don't see myself really using this head because the sunglasses is too awesome. And then this head is more awesome than either of them. Battle damage, showing endoskeleton inside. I want to pop this head on right now. It's so awesome. There we go. Amazing. This first gun is a Winchester model 1887 that Arnold uses when he's on the motorcycle a lot, and he flips it around with one hand, and he's had his hand in this loop, and they had a bigger loop for filming so he could spin around with one hand, and one day Schwarzenegger tried to use the one with a small loop, and he broke 3 fingers, apparently. But what this gun is really missing is the trigger. In the movie, they used a sawed-off trigger guard, but there was still a trigger, and the back half of the trigger guard, but all that's gone from here. But the rest of the sculpt is pretty amazing. Look at the sculpted lines in the wood that even has a dry brush, and look at the sculpted little logo and screw hole. A terrific accessory. Even logos on the other side. Great job on that. Just, where's my trigger? This is his custom 1911A that he steals from the biker at the bar who gets his clothes from, and then later Sarah uses it because she borrows it from the Terminator when they're in the mental hospital. The trigger guard on mine looks kind of warped. Well, at least there is a trigger guard on this gun. Other than that, the sculpt is pretty great. This gun is an M79 grenade launcher. The Terminator uses it to blow up a bunch of police cars. It also has a great sculpt on the wood, but not quite as great as the Winchester, I think, and then this looks a little warped, but the cool thing is it comes with a bandolier of grenades that you saw earlier, and I forgot to mention that's an accessory too. Even though it comes packaged wearing it, it comes right off, so that's totally an accessory. Really great that they included this. The last gun is definitely the coolest. Terminator 2 is all about being cool. It is an M134 minigun with an attached bag of ammo. There are a lot of bullets to be spent. This was the same minigun that Jesse Ventura and Bill Duke got to shoot in Predator, and by the time Terminator 2 came around, it was Arnold's turn. I love that they included this gun. I honestly would have been happy without the ammo bag, but it's cool that they included it, too. I just wish this wouldn't warp so much. I've seen other people's who've warped a lot worse, though. Still, really cool accessory. The Ultimate T-800 from Terminator 2 stands just a hair above 7 inches tall, pretty perfect scale. He definitely fits in with the other figures in Nika's Terminator 2 line. Get out of here. Uh-oh. Here he is next to some other Nika figures, my Scar Predator and a Xenomorph Warrior. And just for fun, here he is next to some of the best superhero figures ever made from DC Universe Classics and Marvel Legends. So this is one awesome figure. Aside from the fact that some of my guns seem to have warped and one of them's missing a trigger, there are really no problems. No problems with the figure itself. It's pretty amazing. And of course, this is the iconic Arnold Schwarzenegger Terminator, the one you have to have. Out of all the Terminator figures, this one's the one you gotta buy. Do I recommend it? Yes. Go out and buy it. Until next time, friends.